A very good afternoon to one and all present in this Zoom meeting. And today I'm going to talk about tenses in English. Okay, so when I say tenses in English, I mean to say I'm talking about, you can say verbs in English. Okay, or you can say in another sense, you can say tenses are also referring to time. Okay, verb and time are both linked to each other. Or in your Hindi, we say I'm talking about Kal. Okay, so as you all know that in English or in any language, when we talk about time, we say there is something called as past, present and future. Okay, there is something called as past tense, there is present tense and future tense. So in Hindi we say Bhutkal, Bhavishyakal, Vartamankal. Okay, past is called Bhutkal, Vartaman is nothing but the present tense and Bhavishyakal is nothing but the future tense. Okay, so whenever we are talking about tenses in English, we are talking about verbs in English. Remember that the part of sentences, which actually part of a sentence is actually telling you whether you're talking about past, present or future in English, okay, is the verb. The verb will tell you whether this particular action happened in the past, or the present or the future. Okay, so first thing is you must remember one important note about the tenses in English. We have only two types of tenses in English, past and present. Now you may be wondering why I'm saying like this. Why is it that we have only two tenses in English? Okay, the reason because the reason behind this is that in English the verbs will change its form only in the past and the present. They don't change the form in the future tense. Okay, that is the reason we say we have only two tenses in English. But that doesn't mean that we cannot talk about future. We can talk about future in English, but how is it possible and how is it that we can talk about future? I'll come to that later on. But as of now, remember the verbs in English can take, will change its form either in the past or in the present. So for the sake of simplicity, we will study all the three types of tenses. You'll come to know why I said there is no future tense in English, because the verb does not change its form. So to elaborate that, let's try to talk about tenses. What is tense in English? How would you define? So I would define tense by saying that tenses are the form taken by a verb to show the time of an action or the state of an event. So this is a simple definition of tense. It is the form taken by a verb to show the time of an action or the state of an event. Okay. So for the sake of simplicity, we shall consider future tense also, but then later on you will find that the verb will not change the form in the future tense. So whenever you are studying tenses, obviously we shall take present, we shall take past and we shall take future also. But you will come to know how future tense is very different in English. So now these present tense, future tense, past, present and future can be further sub-classified into four more types of tense. Okay, they are the indefinite tense. Okay, the indefinite tense. Then you have the continuous or imperfect tense. Okay, then you have the perfect tense and perfect continuous tense. What is the meaning of indefinite? Now, if you look at some textbooks, you will find that some of the authors, they will say indefinite tense and some will say simple tense. They will not say indefinite. But you can use indefinite tense or you can say simple tense also. What is the meaning of indefinite tense? It indicates that, okay, the meaning of indefinite tense means it will not tell you whether the action is complete or not. This is the meaning of indefinite tense. Then the second subclassification is continuous or imperfect. Continuous or imperfect in the sense that the action is going on. When you hear a continuous tense in English, you will find that the action is still going on. Perfect tense in the subclassification perfect tense, okay, indicates that the action is complete, finished or perfect. That means the action is completely done. It is finished, it is over. And perfect continuous indicates that the action began somewhere in the past and it is still continuing. These are the interpretations of the sub-classification of the tenses in English. Okay, so now I'm going to show you a table and you have to look at this table with one example and understand how the verbs are changing its form. Okay, so let us take one verb called as play. Okay, in the present tense, as I said, there are three tenses: present, past, future. Now, present indefinite, present continuous, present perfect continuous. So if you look at this, these are the sub classifications and we shall understand these tenses with respect to the verb. Now in this table, you can see that I'm going to take a verb called as play. Now in the indefinite or simple present tense, let us take the present tense. Okay, let us say play. Now we all know that we all play. Everybody plays, I know that. Okay, we all have the tendency to play. Now some may play badminton, some may play outdoor games, some may play indoor games, whatever it is, we all like to play. Okay, now if I want to talk about present indefinite or simple present, okay, I want to tell what are the things which I normally do daily. Okay, so you say I play badminton, I play Ludo, okay, I play football, I play cricket. This is a simple example of a simple present tense. So what happens in simple present or indefinite? You are just telling what you do daily. What are the things that you do daily? I have taken an example, play. So you may say I play in general, or you may specify I play badminton. Okay, now you can see that when I say I play badminton, you will come to know that action, you will not come to know whether the action is going on or are completed. Okay, and the verb play remains play. Okay, now when it comes to continuous, present continuous, okay, now you can see is, am, and are. Remember, while studying subject verb agreement, I taught you all about first person, second person, third person. Okay, and the verbs, I is a first person. Okay, I is a first person singular, we is a first person plural. Okay, then you, second person singular, and you, second person plural, and third person singular is he, she, it, and third person plural is they. So remember that we were talking about irregular verbs in English. Okay, irregular verbs are, there are three irregular verbs: be verb, have, and do. Now if you look at this, this is an example of be verb. Okay, suppose if I say Ram is playing badminton, so I will use is. Third person singular, you can see is gets added. If I want to tell I am playing badminton, then I will say I am playing badminton. If I want to talk about somebody, third person, okay, you are playing, okay, they are playing, we are playing. So is, am, and are gets added to the verb play, and play becomes ing. So whenever you are talking about continuous, present continuous, first of all, remember that the verb play, ing gets added, and you have to add the be form of the verb before playing. Okay, in this example, play becomes playing, and before playing you can say, you can use the be verb in the first person, second person, or third person. If it is first person, you will say I am playing. If it is third person singular, you will say he is playing, she is playing. If it is any other form of you can say the person. Okay, second person singular, or second person singular, second person plural. Okay, then first person plural, that is we are playing, you are playing, you are playing, they are playing. So what happens here is, or the conclusion is that in continuous, present continuous tense, the play becomes, the verb play becomes playing, ing gets added, and you are using the be form of the verb based on the person. Then when it comes to perfect tense, present perfect, what you have to do is, either you have to say I have played. Okay, if it is third person singular, I will say she has played, he has played. The action tells that the perfect tense tells that the action is complete. So what happens in case of the verb play here? Play becomes ed gets added. Here in the second example, in continuous, ing gets added, whereas in perfect, ed gets added. And you are using the irregular verb have based on which person you are talking about. Either it becomes have or it becomes has. Okay, then perfect continuous means you started an action in the past and you're still doing it. You're not completed it. So what happens here is been gets added. Now again, look at the verb play. The verb play will have ing added to it. And along with that, the verb been gets added. And before been, you can say, I have been. If you're talking about first person singular, then you say, I have been playing badminton ever since my childhood. If you are using third person singular, it becomes she has been playing badminton ever since her childhood. So if you are able to identify, now look at the trick here. The trick here says that in indefinite, okay, simple present or indefinite present, the verb will not change its form. In continuous, ing gets added. Along with that, the be form gets preceded. Okay, in perfect tense, you have to use the irregular verb have, and in the perfect continuous, and the verb becomes here. Sorry, in perfect, the verb becomes ed, and in perfect continuous, you can see that again ing gets added to the verb, and then you're using have been or has been based on the person that you're talking. So if now we shall take some more examples, okay, of the present tense. Now look at this particular table here. Okay, let us start with the first, sing. Okay, in the simple present tense, I say I sing. Very simple, verb is not changing the form. Now when I'm it's continuous, now what happens in continuous? Sing becomes singing. Okay, ing gets added, and then since I'm talking about the first person singular, I say I am singing. Similarly, I say you sing, you are singing. Okay, then I may say we sing, we are singing. He sings, he is singing. Okay, he is, M becomes is. So this you already know, subject verb agreement, the class I have already told you how the irregular verb will change its form based on the person that you're talking about or the subject that you're talking about. But as of now, what you have to remember is we are not talking about subject verb agreement. The topic has already been covered. You have to see how the verb is changing the form. What happens here in simple present, sing remains sing, but in continuous it becomes ing. I am singing. Now in perfect, what happens? Have will get added. I have sung. Now look at the verb sung. Okay, sing becomes a sung in perfect. It has again changed its form. And in perfect continuous, what happens? Sing becomes again singing. Sing becomes again singing. Ing gets added. And you have to add have been. Okay, so what is the conclusion? If it is simple, verb will not change the form. If it is continuous, it becomes ing. If it is perfect, you have to use have, and the verb will change the form. And if it is perfect continuous, you have to make sure you have to write have been without fail. Have been, and then the verb sing becomes singing. Now let's take another example, dance. Now simple, now indefinite present, indefinite or present, simple. I say I dance, very simple, verb is not changing. But if it is continuous, then you have to say I am dancing. Dance becomes ing, dancing. Okay, I am dancing, I am telling you, it's a present continuous action which is happening right at the moment. Perfect, you have to again use have. And dance becomes dance, the verb is changing the form again in perfect tense. Okay, then what do you say? I have danced, because you have to add have here. And what happens in perfect continuous? Have been has to be added. I have been dancing ever since my childhood, like that. Okay, so what you can see here in continuous, wherever there is the word continuous, the verb will be ending with ing. If it is simple continuous, you have to use the be verb. If it is perfect continuous, you have to add have been. That's very simple. And wherever there is perfect, you have to only add have, and the verb will change the form into the past, because just now you have completed that action. Okay, now look at the next example of the verb teach. Okay, I teach English, simple present. I am teaching English right now, this action is happening. Okay, teach becomes teaching. Now teach in the perfect tense, I have taught English. So have will get added to the verb, and the verb will change the form to the past form. I have taught English. Then if it is perfect continuous, it again becomes I have been teaching English from the past 4 years. Okay, then let's take another example, eat. In the simple present, I can eat remains eat. I eat apple, very simple. Then continuous, eat becomes eating, and you have to tell about the current action. So since I'm using first person singular, say I am eating apple. Okay, then if it is perfect, eat becomes eaten and have gets added, I have eaten apple. And if it is perfect continuous, again eat becomes eating, and then again you have to add have been, I have been eating apple. Okay, then another example, I read novel. Read is not changing the form in the present tense, but it becomes read, becomes reading in the continuous. Okay, then you say I am reading novel. Okay, then in perfect tense again you have to add have and read. Now read remains read, but the pronunciation will change. I have read novel, instead of the pronunciation will become I have read novel. And then in perfect continuous again it becomes reading. Again, wherever there is the word continuous, remember ing gets added. You have to remember these simple tricks. Okay, and have been will get added in perfect continuous. Only have will get added in perfect. These, see that I have purposely highlighted those words so that you people will remember what I'm trying to say. Okay, so I have been reading novel ever since my childhood. Again, fine. Then last example, wash. Okay, I wash clothes. Simple tense. Okay, I wash clothes. So wash remains wash only. There is the verb is not changing its form. Then wash becomes washing. Why? Because I'm using continuous. I'm using continuous tense. I am washing clothes right now. The current it's happening. Then what happens in case of perfect? Have gets added and wash becomes washed. So I have washed clothes, and in perfect continuous, I have been will get added in perfect continuous. So if you remember this have been, okay, you will never make any, you will never be confused. So remember, for perfect tense, have gets added before the verb. For perfect continuous, have been gets added. Wherever there is the word continuous, okay, the verb will end with ing, and wherever there is perfect, the verb will take the past form. Okay, so sing became sung, dance became danced, teach became taught, eat became ate, read became read, and wash became washed. So this is a simple trick that you must remember with respect to the present tense. Now in this example, okay, I have taken I. Okay, suppose if I take third person singular, suppose I want to say Anita sings. Okay, what happens here? Anita sings, sing becomes sings. Subject verb agreement, remember. Regular verb become ends with s. As Anita sings, Anita is singing, Anita has sung, Anita has been singing. Why have became? Why is it that I made have to has? Because third person singular. Again, subject verb agreement. Don't forget the rule of subject verb agreement. The example in the table which I am showing you right now is first person singular. But if it is third person, if I say instead of Anita, now let us say I will say Raju. Okay, Raju sings. Let's take example of dance now. Raju dances. Why it became dances? Raju is a third person singular. Then how be verb will change? Raju is dancing. Why is? Because third person singular, subject verb agreement rule. Remember the rule. M becomes is. Raju is dancing. Raju has danced. Have becomes has. Subject verb agreement. Again, try to remember. Then Raju has been dancing. Okay. So this is the subject verb agreement concept remains the same everywhere. Of course, we are not talking about subject verb agreement, but still it is playing a very important role to understand the tenses here, because these irregular verbs are playing a very important part in changing the form of the regular verb. Look at all these examples here. The sing is a regular verb, am is a irregular. So these are all examples of sentences wherein regular and irregular verbs both are playing an important role. Okay, so I hope the present tense, the different categories of present tense, that is simple or indefinite, continuous, perfect continuous concept, you people have followed. Okay, now coming to the next example is the past tense. Now look at the past tense. What happens in past tense? In past tense, simple past or indefinite, play becomes played. It takes the ed form. If it is a regular verb, it takes a ed form. Not all verbs in English take ed form. Just like we see, eat became ate. Okay, sing became sang. Okay, or sung. I mean, this is how generally some verbs will not end with ed. Not all verbs in English end with ed in the past form. So simple. I played badminton. Okay, then now look at this example. I was playing. Now what happens here? Again, the verb. Okay, this is the be verb. The be verb in the past tense becomes was. If I'm using first person singular, it becomes I was playing badminton. Then has or have becomes had. Look at this. In perfect tense, in past perfect, you cannot use has or have. You have to use only had. And in perfect continuous, you have to use, instead of have been or has been, it becomes had been. Okay. So the rule remains same. Wherever there is continuous, see, wherever there is continuous, again the verb is changing to ing form. And wherever there is perfect, it is becoming the past form, that is ed form. Okay. So based on this particular concept, let's again take some more examples of the tenses. Some more examples. Now look at this. Past tense. Okay. Sing. Simple past. I sang song. Past continuous. I was singing song. Past perfect. Now what happens here? I had sung song. Perfect continuous. I had been singing song. So what is the difference? The verb sing, wherever there is continuous, it is becoming ing. Okay. Simple. Now this is, we are talking about past tense now. Sing becomes a sang. I sang song. Sing became sang because it cannot be, it is not present. You just sang the song. Okay. I sang song. Perfect. Now here it becomes sung. I had sung song. But here instead of have, you have to say had. And here in wherever there is perfect continuous, had been will get added. Again, the verb sing ends with ing. See, be it simple continuous, only continuous or perfect continuous. The word, wherever you come across continuous word, okay, the category continuous, verb will end with ing. Okay, so here, now let's take another example. I danced, simple, I danced, I was dancing. I had danced, I had been dancing. So I think now you might have got the idea or the trick that I'm trying to tell you. Where there is perfect, have becomes had in the past tense. And in the perfect continuous, you have to just say had been. Had been, you just add had been and change the form of the verb to ing. Very simple. And wherever there is perfect, based on the verb which you are using, if it is a regular verb that ends with ed, it becomes ed. Now see here, dance. I danced, I was dancing. Okay, I had danced, I had been dancing. So where there is perfect, had will come. Where there is perfect continuous, had been will come. And since we are, wherever the word continuous is there, the verb is changing its form to ing. Okay. So similarly, you can say teach. In the simple past, it becomes I taught English. Continuous. In the past continuous, it becomes I was teaching English. Okay. Then in the past perfect, it becomes I had taught English. Okay. Then the past perfect continuous, it becomes I had been teaching English. Similarly, eat. Now when you talk about eat, past, simple past, I ate apple. Continuous, past continuous, I was eating apple. Past perfect, I had eaten apple. Past perfect continuous, I had been eating apple. Then read. Now remember, there are some verbs in English, like this is a very typical example. Read, read, read. Everywhere it is read, but the pronunciation changes. Okay. See, I read novel. You cannot say I read novel. In the past, you have to say I read novel. Then past continuous, I was reading novel. Then past perfect, I had read novel. See, read, I read novel, I was reading novel. I had read novel, I had been reading novel. Then wash. Okay. Then coming to wash. Now the simple past. Simple past, I washed clothes. Then continuous, past continuous, I was washing clothes. Okay. I was washing. So this is a continuous. No. So because continuous is there, wash becomes washing. Then perfect, I had washed clothes. Okay, I had washed clothes. And then past perfect continuous, I was washing clothes. I was washing clothes. Sorry, I had been washing clothes. So this is how the past will take its form. Now again, in this example, I have taken first person singular. Suppose if you want to take third person singular, and let's take wash again, third person singular. Suppose I want to say that Seema, okay, I want to use the third person singular Seema. Okay, Seema washed clothes. Seema was washing clothes. Seema had washed clothes. Seema had been washing clothes. That's how the change it will try to change. Okay, so you saw that how you, I hope you people have followed. See, what I'm trying to tell you is only the trick, how to remember, how to convert a particular sentence into simple, continuous, perfect and perfect continuous. As of now, I'm just giving you all proper some tricks and hints as to how to write sentences in a proper, because tenses are not only tenses, you have subcategories in it. Okay, now coming to the future tense. Okay, coming to the future tense. If you see in future tense, I told you in the beginning of my class that in future tense in English, the verb doesn't change its form. Because the verb doesn't change its form, in the sense like there is, you won't find much difference in the present and the future, we say there is no future tense in English. Because whatever in future tense in English, if you just add will and shall to the present tense, okay, it becomes future. Now look at the combination. Now look at the simple present. I play badminton, or just I will say I'll play. Here also play remains play. Only thing will and shall. Either you can say I will play or I shall play badminton. Now look at this. I am playing. I shall be playing. Okay. So the verb in the future tense will remain the same as the present tense. Okay. Except that you'll have to say will or shall. Either you say will or shall. So the modal verbs, the will and shall, are called as modal verbs. There is another topic in grammar called modal verbs in English, which you can understand only if you understand tenses. So as of now, remember that will and shall are examples of modal verbs in English. Okay, which are helping verbs. Only if you add will or shall to the present tense. Now see, play, play, playing, playing. So you are saying, I will be playing, I shall be playing. Okay, I have played, I shall have played, I will have played. Okay, I shall play, I will have played, like this. And then perfect, you can see the verb remain the present tense, the sentences in the present tense which are there, if you just add will or shall, it becomes future tense. Okay, so here are the examples. Now you can see I sing, I will sing, I shall sing. So when you just go on adding will or shall to the present tense, okay, it becomes future tense. So future tense, you don't have to worry, it remains the same. You just have to remember the rules only for the present and the past tense. And whenever you want to talk about future tense, you can either say will or shall to the present tense, it becomes future tense. So this is how you get, like for example, we'll take read. Okay, I read novel, I will read novel, or I shall read novel. Then I am reading novel, I will be, now am becomes be in the future tense. Okay, I will be reading novel, or I shall be reading novel. Then I have read novel, simple, will or shall. Just go on adding will and shall to the present tense, it becomes future tense. So this is how you have to make sure that you don't make any mistakes while you're trying to frame sentences in tenses. Okay, so let me just recap what I taught you today. I told you what is a tense in English. A tense is nothing but a verb that takes different form. The way the verb takes the form tells you whether you're talking about the present or you're talking about the past. In English, there are only two tenses, actually only two tenses, that is present and the past, because in the present tense and the past tense, the verbs change the form. In future, the verbs don't change the form. They remain the same as they are in the present tense. But however, we still use future tense while we are talking by adding some modal verbs. So I told you there are four more subcategories of the tenses in English. indefinite tense or present or simple tense. Some authors say present, some authors say simple, and some authors say indefinite. Indefinite tense will not tell you whether the action is complete or not. Continuous or imperfect will tell you that action is still going on. Perfect will tell that the action is completely finished or perfect, it's done. And perfect continuous tells that action began in the past and is still continuing. And then I gave you an example. I showed you this table and I gave you a hint, okay, how the verb in the present tense will remain the same. Simple present, it always remains the same. Play, wash, read, eat, it never changes. In continuous, it becomes ing, be it simple continuous or present perfect continuous, verb becomes ing. And then you're using the be form before the continuous, and has or have will get added based on the person. Okay, and have been or has been gets added in the perfect continuous. Similarly, for the past, simple past, it becomes play, becomes played. All the verbs will change to the past form of the verb. And then for the continuous, again, ing, ing, wherever in case of past, indefinite or simple and perfect, the verb will take the past form. You can see the verb is changing its form. And in simple, that is past continuous, was or were will be added based on the person, first person, second person, singular or plural. And here, instead of have, it becomes had. Here, it becomes had been. And future tense, as I said, remains the same as the present tense. Only thing, you just have to say will or shall in the present tense will tell you that the will and shall will tell that, okay, you're talking about future tense in English. So this is the part one of tenses in English class today. Now in the next class, I am just going to give you all some examples as to when actually in real time, when are we supposed to use which tense and which tenses to be used at what time, okay? Real time examples, okay? When to use the tenses in the proper form while we are conversing in English or while we are communicating in English. That will be taught to you in the second class. That is tomorrow, I will be completing tenses in English. As of now, I hope you people have completely understood the concept of tenses in English. Remember, tenses are nothing but verbs in English. You're talking about verbs. There are three tenses. Each tense is further classified into four types. And you should know. Now, tomorrow's class, I will tell you how to use. I will take real-time examples of present tense, past tense, and future tense. And that's all for the today's class. So, I just hope you have followed. Please reply to me. I hope you all have followed the concept of tenses.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much. We'll meet tomorrow again at 12 o'clock.
Very
no invitation.
Okay.
Now.